Welcome back. What is an Elastic Network Interface, that is ENI? ENI is a logical networking component in a VPC that represents a virtual network card. It can have the following attributes: a primary private IP version 4 address, one or more secondary private IP version 4 addresses, one elastic IP address, that is IP version 4 per private IP version 4 address, one public IP version 4 address, one or more IP version 6 addresses, one or more security groups, a MAC address, a source or destination check flag. Let's talk about the ENI key features. Each instance in your VPC has a default network interface, or we can say that a primary network interface, that is Ethernet 0, that assign a private IP version 4 address from the IP version 4 address range of your VPC, that is virtual private cloud. You cannot detach the default or say primary network interface from an instance. You can create and attach an additional or say secondary ENIs to an instance in your virtual private cloud, but point to be noted that the ENIs should be created within the same availability zone where you have your EC2 instance to which you are trying to attach your secondary ENI. A security group is attached to an ENI, not an EC2 instance. With this approach, you can have multiple routes to the same EC2 instance with different security configurations. You can create a network interface, attach it to an instance, detach it from an instance, and attach it to another instance within the same availability zone. When you move a network interface from one instance to another, network traffic is redirected to the new instance. Now we will see here on this video how we can attach and detach the ENIs to and from EC2 instances. Let's start it now. Okay, we will be going to add here the network interface to the EC2 instance. Let's start the Linux instance first. Once it's started or running, then we will go to add the network interface. As you can see here right now, there is only one network interfaces. Just scroll down to see the network interfaces ID, public IP and private IP address. The interface owner, as you can match here under GAN user profile account, that is the same. Click on interface ID here, we can get this under network and security. First, we will click on Linux server instance to create a new network interface. Before this, we need to check the subnet ID and the availability zone. We have to select here the correct subnet on which our instance will launch. We can cross-check here in instances tab and in right panel under details to get here the subnet ID. First, we will open the subnet ID in new window, and here we can see the availability zone, that is AP South 1A for the subnet, right? This only we have to select for our new network interface. Let's do it now. Click on it, and here we are in new window. We will name it Demo ENI, that is Elastic Network Interface. Now we will select the correct subnet, that is AP South 1A availability zone. We will go for auto assigning the private IP address. Here we have to select the security group, as we have already one security group for Linux server, then we'll go for it. Just click on create network interface. Okay, here we can see the demo ENI under description column. It is successfully created and it is also available to use. You will not get here the public IP address yet, but yes, we'll get a private IP address. Now we will attach this network interface to our Linux instance, and let's see how we can do this. We have to go to Actions tab, click on it to get the attach, then click on it to choose an Linux server instance and go for attach option. Click on it to complete this step. Yeah, here we have successfully attached network interface to Linux instance. Now we will move back to the instances tab, and here we'll select the Linux server instance. You can see here only one network interface right now. No worry, we have to reload the browser to get the effect change. Yeah, it is refreshed and can see that we have get two private IP addresses, which means the Elastic Network Interface connected to this instance. Now we will go to the networking tab to cross check that network interface. Yes, it is showing now two interfaces. We can see here the demo ENI That is our new Elastic Network Interface. As we can see here, the private IP address and the private DNS and so on. Now, I would like to show you how we can attach this ENI to another instance. And for that, we have to launch new Linux instance. Here we will go for it now. Launch a new instance and choose here Linux AMI. Next to choose an instance type, that is t2.micro. Next to configure instance details. For now, we'll go for one instance only. Then next to add the storage. Next to next to assign the security group for this instance, we will go for an existing security group. Then click on review and launch. Then launch it. Select the existing key pair, that is Linux server key pair. Then go for launch the instances. There we are. Great. As you can see this right now, it is showing pending status. We have to wait till it comes up or the instance state shows running. Okay, it is running now. As you can see here, we have two instances are in running state. The last instance is the new one, as we haven't tagged it, so we know it, right? Now, what we have to do first, we will go back to our Linux server instance on which we have attached the new ENI, and then we'll remove this. Click on Linux server, then go to the networking tab, then scroll down to get the network interfaces. We have to choose the new demo ENI ID. Click on it to get the network interfaces windows. Select this first, then go to the action tab, then click on detach to remove it from the Linux instance. Click on to check the enable option for force detachment, then go for detach. It is still in use. Let's reload it. Yes. Now we can see this ENI is available in status. We can attach this to the newly created Linux instance. Now we will again click on this network interface to attach this one. So go on action tab and click on attach to get the attached instance windows. Here we are now. Now we will choose the new instance to attach this ENI, and there we have done it successfully. In this way, we can attach the ENI to any instance when it is available. We can cross check this also on new instance that is attached or connected to the new Linux instance successfully and removed from the old Linux server as well. Now we will detach it again because we don't need it for a long time. As this is my lab, so we'll have to delete it. All have done successfully now. I'm going to end this here now. We have seen what is ENI and how we can create it, attach it to the instance and delete it as well after detach the ENI. See you guys on my next video. Till then, have a great day and bye bye.